everybody for Christmas, but I want to wish everybody a Merry Christmas and a blessed Christmas, and may you and your family be safe, and just have a wonderful holiday. Got a couple on my prayer requests you need to remember: Danny Hyatt, Shirley Robinson. Also remember Julio, last time I talked to him, he was sick. Also, one of our deacons at church, Son of Sam, Red saw across his hand, and they're going to have to may lose some fingers. And also, another member of our church, she had a wreck, and awful stove and stiff, and he would remember Vicki Garrison in your prayers. Sure would be appreciated. Jerry Beeson also. See any others out there that need to have their names added to, or somebody you might know that needs to be put on the prayer list? Those that may not have it is, you know, a lot of us that bless, we got a good warm roof over our head and family, and there's some people that's not blessed with none of those things, and pray for those people, that the Lord will be with them, send a heart around, and that if any way we can, if possible, that we would help somebody along the way. Tonight, if you have any Bibles, I encourage you again always to read with me and check me out. I'm going to be in the Old Testament tonight, then I'll go to the New Testament, talking about the birth of our Savior. And I'm so thankful tonight that he would come into this world and was born and died on Calvary's cross for us, that we through him might have remission of sins. That the first death is no choice to it. We all going to leave this world one day. But there's the second death mentioned in Revelations, is where those that don't know Jesus Christ as their Savior will be cast into the lake of fire with the false prophet and the beast and the Antichrist. The first death we have no choice of, but we do have because Jesus came, we have an opportunity to be spared of the second death, and I thank God for that tonight. I thank God that he saved my soul. I thank God that he saved my family. I got some family members I'd like to see in church, and I pray for them, that you show us each and every day, Lord, that we don't get judgment, Lord, but we get mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you, Lord, as we go into Christmas, Lord, and Lord, we're to think about Christmas all year round. Lord, we thank you that you sent your Son. Lord, knew that he was going to be mistreated, rejected, but Lord, you still sent him because you love us and you want us to have fellowship, us with you, and I thank you for that, God. Lord, and I pray if there's one out there tonight in the sound of this ministry, Lord, that, Lord, not that I get the glory or anyone else get the glory, Lord, but you get the glory, but I pray that you deal with their heart, Lord, and Lord, you not let them be comfortable until I get things made right with you. Lord, I thank you so much. I love you tonight. Lord, we just pray for those on the prayer request list. Lord, you know each and every name. Lord, each and every need, Lord, that's there. And we just, Lord, we put them in your hands tonight because there's nothing we can do with them, Lord. They're too big for us. Lord God, but we know that there's nothing impossible with Jesus Christ. And we thank you for that, Lord, and we call on them promises. Lord, have your will and way here tonight. I pray, Lord, that you just open up your word, I pray, Lord, that you just help me to put self out of the way, that your will be done, Lord. Lord, again, when it's all said and done, I pray for your glory, your praise, your honor, in all things. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You know, the Bible talks about in the Old Testament, I'm going to be reading from Isaiah 53. Isaiah is actually talking about Jesus.